without you though. Oh yeah, it's working. 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 Oh yeah, it's working.
Well, this is where the future comes to play. We're going to see the next class of players that are hoping to take their game to the NBA. But before they do, they have a chance to shine on this stage here for the fans and everyone watching at home. Welcome to the Adidas Rookie Showcase.
All right, so the goal for these players in this game is to improve their draft stock. If you're a scout and you're trying to figure out which guy you want to draft, what sort of characteristics are you looking for on these guys?
Well, everybody understands that it's a talent league. You have to have a certain level of talent to be an effective NBA player. But past that, you have to have some intangibles that allow you to play well with others, like you learned in kindergarten. How do you play well with others? Well, it starts with role acceptance, knowing who you are and what team you're on and what is needed. Secondly, can you guard your own position? Third, do you pursue loose balls? And then I think this thing, Mike, do you have a basketball IQ and do you have the heart for professional basketball?
Hooker from well beyond the arc. Hooker's attempt for three, no good. And we have a foul called against Rozier. And he'll head to the line to shoot two.
Team foul number one for the West.
And he hits the first free throw.
To the line for two.
Able to convert on both free throws. Rozier bringing it up. Porzingis against Cauley-Stein, and he curls in. Three-point attempt. Kristaps Porzingis with a perfect pass.
You need guys who can make shots under duress and pressure. That was a well-defended possession, but that man stuck it even against the best defense.
Inside, the layup, no good.
Driving the ball into the paint is the most important offensive tool in the game. He had
it. Gets it to go. Plus one. The block called against Booker. And it's on to the free throw line. One shot to complete the three-point play.
Terrific concentration to finish the shot and now shoot a free throw.
Whoops, that won't go. Anthony Towns coming across. Booker for two, lets it go. Unable to flip it in.
Really good job clogging the lane right there.
Gets to the rim and lays it home.
Right from the start here in the first half, they've made a conscious effort to move the basketball around and get quality shots.
Russell for two. It's good.
2 points.
Throws it up high. Oh, sloppy with the ball there. Nobody near him. Takes the three. He sinks it.
Big time corner three right there.
Number 32, Carl Anthony Towns.
Fires again. The East with the offensive rebound to keep it alive. Strong at the rim.
A look at the athleticism exploding up to finish with the hammer.
Russell bringing it up here. Lots of room there. Booker's three-pointer won't go.
That's solid offense. Getting their best players, their best shots, and their best spots. It didn't go in, but that's how you win games.
4-2.
Decker for two. Swatted away by Okafor. Decker has the double team converge. In the paint. No doubt about it. He hit him. It's called against Winslow. That's his first. And he'll head to the line with under 2.5 minutes to go in the first quarter. First free throw. Perfect.
Shooting two. Substitutions, Adinas East. Entering the game.
And he makes them both.
Number zero, Emmanuel Boudier.
From beyond the arc. This is from downtown.
Ain't nobody truller than me, ain't nobody truller than Scott. Ain't nobody true, man, I'm taking this spot. Yeah, this shit.
30s in the city moving slow. 30, 35 in for the cold. Only real, keep it flow. Only true, true that I know. Only 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 true that I know.
16, Mick.
Martin Luther King had a dream. Barack Obama had a joke. Gave a to my daddy, mama, I'm on my way home. Feel like you just doing a. It's my man at that store. Black chains, my mom ain't my flossy, and it's fresh soul. Need a all gold. I'm on a roll. Who would bring the gold to heaven? Took your kids to my island like. We gon' take the hood all over like. Yeah, to my island like Coney. We gon' take the hood back like Coney. It's my man, that's dope.
Hey, my ears been burning. I think they talking about us. Might be the reason my palms been itching for weeks. I thought somebody put some him. I hope we got a check on the way. I hope the talk ain't cheap, bro. Cause honestly, we don't do this, even though we love this passion and money. Got a fine line between. We rock stars in search of anything to spin the wheel, anything to turn us up. We call it simple, mix it, throw it in the club. My manifesto is always staying fresh clothes, even if I'm dead, bro, which I never let go. And neither with my best bros. Role model, don't follow with my steps though. A role model, don't follow with my steps though. Jewel of the kids, I don't wanna be the reason that they tread wrong.
This my manifesto. Yeah, I said, this my manifesto.
Yeah, where the, I need inspiration. I'm sick, I always want something, never said. Ain't got no hope left, don't even wanna pray. Had to spend the nights in my granny basement. No dollars in my pockets, man, I can't take this. Can't even with my cousin, she a. That's okay, I still love her. And I'm gon' get this bread with my brothers. Take note, I don't give a bottle. Your negative and energy, I don't with ya. In a black college expo, she ain't with it, then I'm moving to the next. Jacques Cousteau, I hit with the breaststroke. Love that.
Yeah, I said, this my manifesto.
Ready to view the future. Some very special young players will be on display. A chance to see them before they take their talents to the NBA. Welcome to the Adidas Rookie Showcase.
Some of these games, it's a tough barometer to get because the
agendas really are individual agendas, not necessarily team agendas. So how do you balance that in evaluating the play?
Yeah, unfortunately, some of these games can turn into offensive showcases versus hard-fought competition. And you hope that you get some hard-fought competition so you have the ability to really analyze who can do what. But listen, it's not just this game where you're evaluating. You're evaluating over the course of a young player's entire career. So you don't want to put too much pressure on yourself and step outside yourself and be a selfish player. You want to be an unselfish, winning player. And to do that, you got to share. You got to share the ball. You got to share the responsibility. You got to share the dirty work. That's what these young players have to understand.
Gets it off. That's a two-pointer. Misses.
Here we go. We got some.
Blows past the defender. Here's the screen. Porzingis brings it across at the rim. Kristaps Porzingis with a nice look.
You want to keep attacking the basket and get layups around the rim. That's how you score consistently.
Now he accelerates to the rim. Unable to bring it home. Oh, a ferocious dunk.
Oh, that's nice right there. The finish at the rim with a nice dunk.
Two minutes gone by in the first. The East down by two.
From deep in the corner.
And the rebound grabbed by Anthony Towns.
Thank you.
is yours now for this collection of impressive young talent. Here's your chance now to see the next wave of great young players before they become NBA stars. Welcome to the Adidas Rookie Showcase. All right, so the goal for these players in this game is to improve their draft stock. If you're a scout and you're trying to figure out which guy you want to draft, what sort of characteristics are you looking for on these guys?
Well, everybody understands that it's a talent league. You have to have a certain level of talent to be an effective NBA player. But past that, you have to have some intangibles that allow you to play well with others, like you learned in kindergarten. How do you play well with others? Well, it starts with role acceptance, knowing who you are and what team you're on and what is needed. Secondly, can you guard your own position? Third, do you pursue loose balls? And then I think this thing, Mike, do you have a basketball IQ and do you have the heart for professional basketball?
Oh, he misses a pair of free throws. And now he moves around the defender. Can't get the layup to go. He curls. Looks to put it back up again.
The East with
the offensive rebound for a new 24. It's good. A two-pointer.
4-2. The assist from number 8.
Russell moves into the front court. Oh, bad decision. Puts up the shot from there. Won't go from three-point range. Stein fires while off balance. Moves around the defender. Lets it go. Knocks it down.
2 points.
Gets the wide open look for three. Hooker's long-range jumper won't go.
It's a make-or-miss league. If they're to win this game going forward, they're going to have to make these open shots.
To the rim. Knocks it down for two.
Sometimes the simplest plays are the hardest ones to execute. Good layup.
Number 16.
Throws the alley-oop. Whistle sounds. Out of bounds, so it'll be East ball. Puts it up from three-point land. No go from beyond the arc.
He's a great shooter, but he could have driven the ball into the paint and made a...
Off the alley-oop, he lays it in.
The assist from number 1, Jakari Johnson.
Fires from downtown. Nails the three.
Made the most of his opportunity and he knocked it in. Three ball.
Number 12.
Russell walks it across. Blocked by Okafor. From way downtown. Paulie Stein's jumper for three. Won't go. Throws it down hard.
Oh, that's a sweet finish right there. Dunking the ball with strength and force.
Number 16.
Anthony Towns for two. Puts it up. Unable to flip it in.
Another good offensive possession. Unfortunately, missed the shot.
Justice Winslow with the ball in control.
2 minutes left in the first quarter.
Three left on the 24. He fires it through. Misses it. And the lead still in single figures. Decker against Rozier. Oh, he stepped on the line. Turnover.
It's not going to happen for him. They're not getting back in this game if they continue to make these critical mistakes like stepping out of bounds.
Curling in. What's going on? Jeff, they won't call timeout. They need it.
Mike, I don't like to second guess, but I'm surprised they haven't called a timeout right here. I know some coaches like to let their players play through the swings of the game, but right here, a timeout is warranted.
Looking to curl in for the layup, able to put it in.
That's just a nice layup right there.
It up from downtown. Bang.
Hey, you kid, look at the technique on that three-point shot. The rhythm, the bounce, the arc, the follow-through. That's a thing of beauty.
Russell against Rozier goes to the goal. No good on the layup attempt.
No paint game, no winning. You've got to get the ball at the basket, and then you've got to finish when you get it there.
Kaminsky's looking to set up in the paint to the basket and gets it to go.
Look, you can't give up layups like that. You got to protect the basket and the paint at all costs.
Alice Jefferson draws the double team to the basket, flips it up. Oh, difficult shot against the double team.
That was the absolute definition of a poor shot. But it's hard not to smile when you see it go in. That was a gamble that somehow paid off.
Second quarter, ready to get underway, and a nice comfortable lead for the home team. They set the tone early nicely.
They did. They played a solid first quarter. You're not going to blow teams out that are ready to play, but you get it possession by possession, and they built them a workable margin.
Swats that away. And it's a backcourt violation, so it'll be East ball. Rozier against Moutier. Curls in to the rim and flips that one in.
That's nice body control right there on that layup. Good finish.
Moutier against Rozier.
What's that cutter? What's that cutter? What's the cutter? What's the cutter?
Let's it go. It's good. A two-pointer. The West down by 15.
You're not going to see a better possession in the NBA from both sides of the ball. Good defense, good offense. Good offense won out that time.
The assist from number 12, Terry Rozier.
Moutier set to bring it up. Wallace Jefferson jump shot, knocks it down. That's a two-pointer. West shooting 35% from the field.
36.
Puts it up. Nice soft touch at the rim.
2 points.
When everybody is involved in touching the ball, like what's happening here in the first half, and you've got your assist total up, then you're going to create also a defensive intensity at the other end of the floor. And that's exactly what has happened here in the first half.
And it's back. To the free throw line for two more free throws.
Foul. Team foul number one.
Can't connect on the first free throw.
Substitutions, Adidas West. Substitutions, Adidas East.
Misses the second one as well.
Russell into the front court. Russell against Rozier. From three-point land, Russell shot from downtown won't go.
Here we go. I got him. Take that.
Fires for three from the corner. Shot from downtown, no good.
No question, they've dug themselves a huge hole here in the first half because they haven't been defensively dominant. But the way to get back in the game is contest shots just like that.
Throws it down, what a play!
A look at the athleticism exploding up to finish with the hammer.
Fires for two. Moutier's shot won't go. And he curls in inside. Gets it to go. 21-point lead for Adidas.
Right from the start here in the first half, they've made a conscious effort to move the basketball around and get quality shots.
There's the pick. Fires with two on the clock. Can't get it to go. Porzingis against Anthony Towns. And now he moves around the defender. Porzingis fires with two on the 24. No good. Russell fires with the off-balance shot. Russell's attempt won't go. Unable to flip it in.
Remaining in the second quarter.
Rozier into the front court. Finds a space and takes the wide open three. Can't hit from downtown.
A good offense is all about finding an open shot. They had an open one, they missed it, but that's still good offense.
Anthony Towns fires for three. Won't go from downtown. A minute and a half remaining in the second. The East up by 21. Gets past the defense. Nice. It's good. And one. He got there late. The foul called against Okafor. And he'll head to... the line with a chance to complete a three-point play.
First foul in the last 2 minutes.
Able to convert the free throw, and he completes the three-point play.
To the line for one.
Quick move to get inside. Gets it up for two. Nails it.
4-2.
And we have a timeout called here in the late stages of the first half.
Have you considered a luxury box for your next group event? Availability is limited, so you must act now. Visit our team website for more details.
Cauley Stein jump shot. West with the offensive rebound for another possession. Oh, he shoots it, converts on the inside. 1 minute remaining in the half. The East up by 18. Reverses, puts it in, a two-pointer. 20-point lead for East.
See, that's their problem there defensively. They're allowing the ball to get deep in the paint and right at the basket. You cannot defend like that and win basketball games.
They get him for stepping out of bounds. From downtown, knocks down a three-pointer.
Tremendous balance. Follow through, arc, rotation. Wow.
Sloppy ball handling. Booker jump shot. Pretty assist.
3 points. The assist from number 00.
Puts it up for two. It's good.
16. 2 points.
Buzzer sounds, and the first half comes to an end. The East up by 22. And welcome back again, everyone. Along with Jeff Van Gundy, I'm Mike Breen. The East is dominating, as we've seen all season with that first half performance.
This is one of their best games of the year. They have really played outstanding basketball, and they have earned this big margin.
Russell fires, no defender even close. Can't get it to go down.
That's good offense. Wide open jump shots are what you're trying to create. They created one. Unfortunately, they're missing here tonight, and they missed another wide open look.
There's the double team. Has to adjust. Nicely done. Right there, and it won't fall.
Listen, they're down big in the second half. Anybody can give in right now. I like to see players who are willing to play the full 48 minutes and contest shots just like that.
Blows past his man. Double team, still puts it up. That's a two. He's shooting 65% from the field. Fires away from downtown, and that's his fifth rebound of the game. He curls, two defenders, and he gets the shot off. Knocks it down, beats the double team for two.
Okay, now that's just lucky. No one makes a game plan based on forcing shots through double teams. That was just pure luck, and he got his wish granted.
Gets to the rim. Flips it up, won't go.
They've been strong defensively tonight, but not right there. Right there, they were lucky when they missed at the rim.
I got him. I got him. Here we go.
Gets past the defender.
Rotate. Flashing, flashing, bump him. I'm in.
Rozier against Booker.
Double.
Fires the three with two left on the 24. Timeout call. They need a 20. All right, what kind of strategy might be at play here?
When you're using your 20-second timeout, it can be done for different reasons. Here, I think what they're using it for is a quick play to break this run and try to get a well-executed hoop coming out of the timeout.
Anthony Towns looking to dupe the defense, draws the double team.
Clearly a foul called against the East. Their first team foul. And it's on to the line for a couple of free throws. First free throw, good.
To the line, shooting two.
Goes 2 for 2 at the line. They double him. They're all over him. Still puts it up. Hits the shot.
The East up by 29.
Decker fires away, unable to flip it in. Beats his man. He puts it up. Knocks it down. A two-pointer.
4-2.
Russell against Rozier. Anthony Towns for two. Shoots away.
Not that time.
Shoots the three. Won't go from outside the arc. Loses control. Here's a steal. It's just him in the basket. Throws down the dunk.
Oh, that's nice right there. The finish at the rim with a nice dunk.
Telegraph that pass for the turnover. Oh, he beats the defender. To the reverse. Nails it. That's a two-pointer. And it's a 35-point lead for the East.
At halftime, they had to make offensive adjustments, and they have. And they have come out and put on a great show offensively.
4-2. 2 minutes left in the third quarter.
Moves around the defender. Goes for the three-pointer.
Bang!
From downtown.
3 points.
And the West calls timeout. Nothing working at this point.
Your job as a coach is try to keep the game close. Here, they just totally mismanaged their timeout by allowing their opponent to go on this huge run and then calling the timeout. Why call a timeout now? The game is basically over. You've allowed the lead to balloon.
We have a couple of substitutions here.
Adidas West. Substitutions. Adidas East.
That's a three-pointer. The defense nowhere near him. Knocks it down. The West's 2 for 8 from the perimeter.
Oh, beautiful footwork right there to stay in bounds, rise up, and knock in the three ball.
As the shot clock expires. Oh, he got hit on the shot attempt. Couple of free throws coming up.
That's his first personal foul. Team foul number one. That's the first foul in the last.
Knocks down the first one.
Same shot, same shot.
Boy, misses the second free throw. He goes 1 for 2.
One minute remaining in the third quarter.
Anthony Towns fires. The West with the offensive rebound for a second chance opportunity. Rozier in possession. Kaminsky's looking for position in the paint. The two defenders converge. Off balance, he fires for three. Misfires from beyond the arc.
You never know in this league. You just work for 48 minutes. Challenge shots, make it hard on the other team. You can get back in the game.
Plenty of time. That's a three-pointer. Curling in, adjusting on the shot. And that'll do it. Three quarters complete. The East up by 32. We'll have more Friday Night NBA from ESPN after the break. Set to start the fourth quarter, first couple of minutes critical. You don't want to think they have any chance to get back into it.
Put your foot on their throat and squeeze the life out of them. Go for the jugular right now. Don't wait. Don't play the score. Play the game well.
Bang! Hits from downtown. The West's 3 for 9 from outside.
Sweet stroke on that shot, Mike. It looked good as soon as it left his hand.
And puts it in.
All kinds of confidence on that three-pointer. Great-looking shot.
Alice Jefferson against Porzingis. Oh, quick move, gets inside. In the paint, not able to score.
Hey, that's a team playing the score, not the game. That's too easy of an attempt, even though you have a big lead.
Rozier's trying to get down low. At the rim, lays it in.
That's just a nice layup right there.
The assist from number 16.
Wide open for three. Misfires from long distance.
Hey, look, they're getting blown out here in the second half. They haven't played well. But if they keep creating these wide open shots, it will pay dividends going down the stretch of this game and in the games coming up.
Moutier bringing it up. Moutier jump shot. Can't connect from way downtown.
Here we go. I got him. I got him. Here I come. Here
double
I
team
come.
Closing
come
in.
Come through.
For two, unable to flip it in.
I like it. I'm seeing more effort in the last couple minutes than we saw in the first half. It may not result in a win here tonight, but the effort is something they can build on going forward.
Hollis Jefferson fires away for two.
Here we go. I got him. Chop. Here we go. Go to the
slams it down.
Oh, look at the athleticism exploding up to finish with the hammer.
And Kevin McHale calls timeout. This one's starting to get away from him. Looks like some substitution is going to be made now for the team.
Number one,
Russell against Rozier.
Subbing in for the East. Number five, Bobby Portis.
Riley Stein shot thrown right back at him. No good from downtown. Looking to curl in. Turner's looking to do damage in the paint. Curls in.
Double team.
Smothering double team. Defense, and he gets the shot up. Touch there, not this time.
Hey, you can sugarcoat it, but this is a disappointing effort. One good challenge doesn't cover up the multitude of defensive sins that have gone into this game.
Knocks down the jumper for three. Willie Cauley-Stein with 7 points and one assist.
You're in tight quarters when you're behind the three in the corner. Good job keeping his feet inbound, rising up, and making the three.
Three and a half gone by in the fourth. The East up by 33. Nice move into the paint. For the layup. Nice adjustment, but can't get it to go.
NBA defense is predicated by protecting the basket. Great defense in the paint tonight to discourage all drives and finishes.
For three, the wide open shot. A long range jumper is off the mark.
It's just been one of those nights. Good open shots that have gone missed. It's a make or miss league. Unfortunately, tonight, they've missed.
The East with control on the rebound. Knocks down the shot. And the West calls a timeout. Looks like it's going to be a full one. To the rim, an easy layup, and it won't go. And a nice finish at the basket. Devin Booker with 10 points. Double team, able to get the shot off. For three, nails it from downtown. The West's 5 for 15 from long range.
Excellent balance. Beautiful release. Knocked it in.
Puts it in. That's a two-pointer.
Beautiful dribble drive and layup.
He's got the room. Now fires. Anthony Towns unable to knock it down. The two defenders swarm. To the rim. Hits for two. And it's a 34-point lead for the East.
You want to keep attacking the basket and get layups around the rim. That's how you score consistently.
Decker for two. Lets it go. Decker's shot, no good.
There's slippage right now. Their paint defense is not nearly what it was to get this lead.
Jump shot won't go. Russell has the double team close in. Wide open for three. Hooker's off the mark from downtown. Gets inside, takes it to the rim.
Fundamentally sound ball handling right there. Kept it low, got the blow by to the basket, and a nice finish.
Booker for two. He knocks it down. Beautiful feed for the assist.
The assist from number one, Nikari
Collins. Ball knocked loose. Reaches in, taken away by Russell. And this contest is over. The final score is 74 to 40. For Jeff Van Gundy and our entire EA Sports crew, this is Mike Breen saying thanks for joining us and good night.
David Rose here, and I've got your EA Sports post-game wrap-up. The East put their opponents away in a blowout. you ask me, and I'll tell you, it was the ball movement that made all the difference. There's something to be said for a team that can win as a group. And that's what happened here today. What you see here is how the majority of the points were scored for the East. The West are no longer suffering through what was a big-time blowout. Losses like this become main discussion topics in the media. So hopefully this team is ready to answer the tough questions. It's not going to be fun.
Game track. Defense.
East put under pressure defensively in this game. And in return, they put back some blocks and steals on the stat sheet. Not only that, they put a W in the win column. And that's everyone's favorite stat.
Player of the game.
Mark really showed off his talents in today's matchup. When you're the game leader in points, it's hard not to stand out. And he did exactly that in today's matchup. He was most destructive in the paint, really establishing himself around the rim. The defense struggled to stop him and never really figured him out.
Who was cold?
What can you say about a guy like this? Except that he fits the title of this segment. He was definitely cold in this game. We got our top three plays for you. And that does it for our post-game wrap-up. On behalf of ESPN on EA Sports, I'm Jalen Rose. Thanks for joining us.
NBA Live. 16.
I'm the only doing that you weather. Ruining them too legit, go hammer with the foolishness. My nana said my grandma can maneuver this industry until I'm stupid rich, and now I'm stupid rich. Ah!
Now that you put your game on display for the scouts, it's time for the NBA draft. Players always remember the day they were drafted. In one moment, your lifelong dream becomes a reality. It's surreal to hear your name called, walk up on the stage, and shake hands with the commissioner. The whole experience is amazing. A big day for everybody. Now it's your turn to begin your NBA career.
welcome to the Sleep Train Arena in Sacramento, California. It's the NBA on ESPN Wednesday as we get set for the first game of the season between the Sacramento Kings and the LA Clippers. Here we are, the first game of the season, and Jeff, this is just a special time. Everybody's undefeated, and it's a season of hope and promise.
Everybody's optimistic right now, but reality will strike 20 games into the year, and you will know who the pretenders are and who the contenders are.
The tip and the game underway. Jeff, the Clippers, not only good, but so entertaining. It's a highlight package every night.
Absolutely, and again, those highlights get special significance when it comes to they're in winning to make highlight reel plays in a forgotten very quickly. But to do entertaining style and win in a major market like L.A., and really right now be the better team in L.A., this is a terrific accomplishment for Doc Rivers and his team.
Redick jump shot. This fires from three-point range. Tries the lob and goes out of bounds. Los Angeles is leading Sacramento by a score of 3-2.
It looks like we have a little player shuffling going on here.
Sacramento Kings, number 30, Curry.
First of all, he is desperate to get to a finals, desperate for a championship, but his team not able to get past the second round. What does he have to do to take them there, Jeff?
Well, Chris Paul is a great player. Oftentimes, how far you advance in the playoffs is just as much about who you play with and who you play against as it is how you play individually. Chris Paul has nothing to be ashamed about. This is a team that could win it all.
You know, Jeff, here's a little known fact about Chris Paul. You know he's a great basketball player. Do you know he was a great bowler? He actually owns a bowling franchise in the PBA League.
In the matchups right now, both coaches trying to make some changes.
Into the game for the Sacramento Kings, number 41, Costa Kufas.
Goes to the goal. Rebound corralled by Jordan. It in. Los Angeles 2-for-5 from three-point territory.
You can tell both of these teams are completely unselfish with the basketball. Look at the assist total, and you can tell that both teams have learned very well that sharing is the true joy in this game.
Three and a half gone by in the second. Sacramento's down by four.
Redick for two. Puts it in. And J.J. Redick with 5 points here on the second.
You need guys who can make shots under duress and pressure. That was a well-defended possession, but that man stuck it even against the best defense.
Hey, Jeff, Cousins has already put up some good numbers. What's the next step for him?
Well, it's always maturity, Mike. Maturity and winning. And I think he's shown signs of maturing. You know, now, does it have to be more consistent? Absolutely. Is he starting to get it? I think so.
There's the double team. Redick jump shot. Bang! He's 3 for 4 from the outside.
We're seeing a lot of offensive energy on the floor from both of these teams with terrific ball movement.
Redick, the rebound. To the basket. Makes the adjustment, but misses.
The defensive timing in when to come to double is critical. You come high, hard, and to the offensive player's body so that there is no room to split or get to the basket. What you want to do is either force the pass or the jump shot.
Shoots it for two. Able to knock it down.
He's got 6 points in this game. That's a 16-6 run for the Clippers.
To the basket, flips it up, gets it to go. The Kings down by 6.
Hey, you can only control what you can control. The defense there was great. It was just a better shot.
Redick fires for 3 from the corner. Not able to hit from downtown. For 2. Draws the foul. It's called against Jordan. And DeMarcus Cousins will go to the line with under 20 seconds to go in the first half.
That's the first foul in the last 2 minutes.
And he connects on the first free throw.
Substitutions, Sacramento.
DeMarcus Cousins with 6 points. It'll count if it goes. And time expires here to end the first half. Sacramento's down by 4. Stay tuned for more Wednesday Night NBA presented by ESPN on EA Sports after this short break. Welcome back to the Sleep Train Arena for the second half of this basketball game. Along with Jeff Van Gundy, Mike Breen on hand. Sacramento's in a close ball game once again as we head to the second half, but they're just a few points behind.
Yeah, I like the position they're in right now. They're down, but they're not out by any means. They have just got to stick with their game plan, do what the coaches say, and get more people stepping up, stepping forward, and making some shots.
Fires away for 2. Can't connect.
I remember Jeff Doc Rivers saying when he coached the Celtics and Rajon.
And we have a substitution here.
Substitutions, Sacramento.
Let's it go for two. That's good. The Kings up by two. Two puts it up. His jump shot won't go.
LA's not having the kind of offensive consistency you need to win in this league. They just can't seem to get into a rhythm.
To the rim. That's good. For two. Sacramento's shooting 56% from the field.
The ball movement in this game has been phenomenal, forcing a lot of defensive rotations and ultimately a lot of passes leading to direct scores.
Gets into the paint. Inside. Flips it up for two. What a play.
That's just a nice layup right there.
Oh, he loses it. Oh, quick hands reaching in for the steal. Gets to, oh, what a play.
Oh, that's nice right there. The finish at the rim with a nice dunk.
The assist from number 23, Ben McElroy.
And it's a 24-second violation.
Look, it happened. Shot clock violations are part of the game, but they're ones that you have to constantly try to erase these type of mistakes. You need to get shots at the basket and not have the clock run out.
With the runner. Oh, he knocks it down.
2 points.
Sacramento's leading Los Angeles by a score of 53. To 45. Here's the pick. Ahmed swats that one away.
Are you kidding me?
Sacramento's making a few subs here. Looks down the other end of the floor. Takes the three. Offensive rebound. Attacks the basket. Can't knock it down.
Driving the ball into the paint is the most important offensive tool in the game. He had a great look. He just missed it.
Puts it up for two. Oh, pretty move into the paint. Oh, nice touch from Chris Paul. Oh, what a costly turnover.
What was he thinking on that play? Who was he trying to pass to?
Get him for the foul. They had to do it to stop the clock.
That's his first personal foul. Team foul number two.
And this one ends here. The final score is 58 to 53. For Jeff Van Gundy and our entire EA Sports crew, this is Mike Breen saying thanks for watching and good night.
Here we go with the EA Sports post-game wrap-up. The Kings edged out a close victory in today's game. You ask me, and I'll tell you, it was the ball movement that made all the difference. There's something to be said for a team that can win as a group, and that's what happened here today. Check out the leading scores for the Sacramento Kings. The Clippers are probably frustrated with themselves after such a narrow loss. Chemistry was clearly not the issue today, because they were definitely sharing the ball well. Still, everyone knows they'd rather be sharing the joy of a victory. Here are the guys who put up the most points for the Los Angeles Clippers.
Game track. Points in the paint.
This was a game for old school fans of basketball. The way these players worked in the paint, earning points the hard way, definitely put a smile on my face. Let's check out the game stats.
Player of the game.
On behalf of ESPN on EA Sports, I'm Jalen Rose, and it's been our pleasure to present you with some NBA basketball.
NBA Hall of Famer Larry Bird recently said he's in favor of adding a four-point line. Golden State head coach Steve Kerr is opposed to the idea. When it comes to putting a four-point line on the court, I'm totally with Steve and against Larry. I like the game the way it is. Already there's a major emphasis on the three-point shot, and in some cases, players shooting multiple threes per game that would be a lot more effective handling the basketball in mid-range or driving towards the hoop. I would not want to see a four-point shot.
And say I did it again and did it a third time, and know that the third time was the Trinity coming. Coming up from a section where everyone is gunning for the exit until it's roped off, like. Can't say they caught me on the ropes, nor can they ever say they took me in a hope. My hope was tucked under my know-how. Know-how made it the way I know, PLO style. So one time for the method I chose, and if you tied those together.